and we're here me. Live. It's in Las Vegas, Nevada. And what a show we're going to have for all of y'all. I'm excited, amigos.
And now our next match.
Title versus career as Tammy challenges Diana Diamond for the XGWL Women's World Championship and Diana Diamond's final match in CAW. And now making her way to the ring, the Queen Bee, the leader of the Beehive, as you see there, Tammy making her way to the ring. So this is going to be the last time we see Tammy in an XGWL ring.
Yeah, because you know she'll get by elsewhere. As we see the final ride for one Diana Diamond.
And Diana Diamond has had such a great career.
Sherman Samson is about to make the descent out of the cave. for his own sake. That's extreme. Tony tries to get up, but it's just too late. And as Sherman makes the second fall of the match,
XT started a fight back.
Both men are fighting back. It's a damn free fall for that title.
Both these men know what's at stake here for the biggest prize in XGWL. And Sherman Samson grabbing the title once again after knocking down XT. And he gets the title. XT's trying to come back. Back up his feet, it's too late. Sherman Samson with the victory. Sherman Samson is still your XGWL Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion. Welcome, amigos, XGWL Charge, episode 91, and we're finally back after a bit of a hiatus, amigos, and we're here live in parts unknown in San Diego, California, because of the current outbreak. But anyway, amigos, glad to be back. Hector Diaz, Chris Gary, and Baxter Helms at the helm here for the commentary team, and amigos, welcome back.
Welcome. What's good, y'all? Welcome back to the Shiznit. But most importantly, guys, it's been crazy happenings in the XGWL. And before I get up to this ring and do some ring announcing, we got a hell of a night here tonight.
Absolutely, here for a debuting Terra Toxic is going to be taking on Ruby Carter. Should be an interesting debut here for Terra Toxic. And also, speaking of debuts, Aussie Andy.
Yes, the one-man Aussie fight train, I guess.
Man,
he's gonna actually collide with a real train in El Toro, Extremo.
And what a...
That, like...
But first, our opening concert here, the two more debuts of the team of Estrella Azul and Jacob Gutierrez taking on the team of Brandon Thomas and Pentagon Jr. Damn. What a way to start things off here. But also, we're also going to have a match for the XGWL professional title as the pro champion, Aaron Spector, who defended the title in a triple threat match against Quick Acid and Tommy Kazarian.
Respectively, they are the team of Jacob Gutierrez and Estrella Azul. Blue Star!
song here is called Soy Mexicano by Mr. Shadow. As Jacob Gutierrez and Sasu are getting ready, now making his way to the ring. Thomas, former Crusader champion, former gear champion, been in XGWL for since the beginning, back in 2007.
Definitely.
This guy scares me. Pentagon Jr.?
Definitely. He had a hellacious match against Vampiro back in Lucha Underground.
Yeah, but what about that movie does where he tries to intentionally break his opponent's arms?
Oh my god, that's so vicious.
But he's also part of the Lucha Brothers in this one wrestling promotion. I think they're considered all elite, if I'm not mistaken.
That is true. Holy, yeah.
Well, duh, I mean, we see them every Wednesday night. But it's not about Wednesday nights, it's about right now. Estrella Azul and Jacob Gutierrez in the blue.
Brandon Thomas in the black and red, and of course Pentagon Jr. on the other side of Brandon Thomas in the silver and black. And oh, nice Hurricanrana to kick things off by Estrella Azul, Blue Star.
And the forearm shot as a receipt there now. Oh, with that, just stomping on the arm of Estrella Azul, and damn, returning the favor there with a jawbreaker. Oh, counter by the veteran.
Well, Brandon Thomas is no stranger to tag team competition, because him and Chris are like Johnson or a team, and Cash rolls everything around me. Also, Russ Cream and Aggression Championship Wrestling. And former Aggression Championship Wrestling tag team champions.
And I have to say, they are a pretty good team over there. And like I was saying, as Brandon Thomas made his entrance to the ring, he is a former Crusader and Pure Champion here in XWL. And now, the tag to Pentagon Jr. And oh, goddamn, good teamwork there.
Mm-hmm. And as far as Pentagon Jr. matches go, as we see Jacob Gutierrez in the ring and clotheslining and knocking down Pentagon Jr., I can't help but forget at a certain all-in event, Pentagon Jr. made a hell of a name for himself against a man named Kenny Omega.
Damn. One thing, there's a lot of great talent in that promotion. Kenny Omega, I also remember him in a match against one Chris Jericho at this place called Wrestle Kingdom.
Yes.
Oh, I should point out that, you know, this promotion actually had this one Bunny who actually wrestles in the
Russian
Championship
Wrestling. Yes, we know. Let's not try and downplay our illusions here, as we see Pentagon Jr. just tossing Jacob Gutierrez back and forth.
And now Pentagon Jr.
Wait a minute, it's 180 off the top rope by Pentagon Jr.
One thing is,
a man of zero fear, as we know.
One thing is that he's not letting up, but there's a lot of fight left in Jacob Gutierrez, and oh, what a snap suplex. because he is a former WCDL champion, as is Estrella Azul. And
yeah, and as is another man we're going to see later on tonight, Jamari Mito. And oh, nice head scissors.
Yes, and also the debut of Nathan Brisbane.
Exactly. I mean, so much beef, you thought he was lugging around a full cow.
But one thing is, this is their official debut because they've been working the house shows every Sunday. You can check that out on YouTube.
Mm-hmm. 11:30 p.m. Eastern, 8:30 p.m. Pacific. Oh, inverted slam by Pentagon Jr. I don't know what the fuck to call that, but it was damn sure effective.
Absolutely. I mean, a modified fisherman buster and oh, working on the arm there of Pentagon Jr.
Modified my nuts. I think that if there was any torque behind that move, Jacob Gutierrez's neck would have been snapped like a motherfucker.
And what a drop toehold by Jacob Gutierrez and trying to get the crowd behind him.
Yeah, he's trying to get the crowd behind him knowing that seconds earlier he could have had a broken fucking neck.
Well, sometimes that adrenaline can overcome such painful acts that's been performed upon you.
Right, of course.
And now Gutierrez stayed on the offensive. And look at this! Ooh!
Oh, nice! The Tiger slam into an armbar, and let's see if... No, wait, Pentagon Jr. Break it out of it.
We thought we were going to see somebody get snapped into an armbar, but no, and anyone! Even someone with zero fear on their back and in their heart can do a Russian leg sweep. Hashtag fact.
And the one thing is, Pentagon Jr. is not relenting here as he's keeping the offense going against Jacob Gutierrez. And wait, what's he doing?
Oh shit.
Oh!
Another inverted fisherman's buster that could have snapped Jacob Gutierrez's neck like a fucking twig.
Man, look at the fight in Jacob Gutierrez. Look at that arm drag. Ooh-wee.
I mean, come to think of it, don't y'all see something like, for example, considering the fact that Lucha Libre is a mix of styles, don't y'all see something in this combination right now? Uh-oh, what the hell is going on here? Jacob Gutierrez, he's trying to something vicious.
I know he's going for here.
Through the ropes, tornado DDT. Not even through the ropes, but his hand could have gotten caught on that ring post. Oh!
Goddamn!
Is Pentagon Jr. busted open?
I think he is.
Well then shit, we got a bleeder already.
And like my good friend the Stats for Danny Duncan would say, busted open to the white meat.
Exactly. But I don't think that Pentagon Jr. gives two flying fucks about, you know, getting busted open until the white meat shows. He's there to prove how relentless he is and how much of a badass he can be.
I mean, he's done that many times. Let's see if he can prove it one more time. And, ooh, what a gut buster by Gutierrez.
Mm-hmm, exactly. All that fear ain't gonna stop you from getting your chest lit up.
Ooh-wee! What a running knee by Pentagon Jr. Cover! One, two!
No, two, ooh. No. Two and three quarters.
Oh, is Brandon Thomas getting the action here?
Brandon Thomas is trying to interject himself in the matchup.
Oh, shit.
Package pile driver!
That has got to be it. Cover! Two and 99%
on that one. If there ever was one. And again, Jacob Gutierrez's neck must be taking the worst of this punishment.
Absolutely not. And I think Pentagon Jr. might be looking for a tag, and he does so. And, ooh, good teamwork.
Well, yeah, good teamwork from the man of zero fear and Hotlanta's finest Crucero and a net break high by Brandon Thomas as he gets into the ring for probably the first time tonight. Actually, the second time. Who the fuck am I kidding?
And now, what's he doing here? And wait. Oh, what a clothesline.
He just smacked him down like he owed him money. And jumping complete shot. A jumping reverse complete shot by Brandon Thomas. As Brandon Thomas is looking for some way to take advantage. No, he takes a cover instead. One, two, three. Holy shit. Let me go ahead and make this official while y'all talk about it.
God damn, I can't believe that Brandon Thomas got the win there. Anyway, as we go through the highlights of this one. What a way to start things off here between these two teams. A lot of debuts in tonight's show. Even though Estrella Azul and Jacob Gutierrez didn't get the win, but I mean, they impressed me so far. Hopefully this won't be a long string of losses, but anyways, let's take a commercial break here, but we'll be back with more action here on XGWL Charged, episode 91. And folks, we're back here with more XGW, and there's Trey Seal making his way to the ring.
Wait, well, this is Victor Purple Rain himself. Trey Seal, how's it going, buddy? How's your buddy, Apollo? Oh, wait. Looks like I have Spector
too. He's tired. You guys are gonna pay for what you did to Apollo with your little buddy there, Eric Spector. Who do you think you are?
Oh, I am? I'm Sherman Samson. I'm the guy that got pushed around in like a little punching bag in every CAW, and I got fed up with that bullshit. That's who I am. The guy that's pissed off at the fucking company. Not just XGWL, but every other CAW that I did.
Well, you seem to be doing pretty well for yourself as the XGWL Ultimate Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah. Don't take it. Company just thanks for the
me
and my buddy
Aaron,
my family.
Family, you say, huh? They might be a bunch of hired guns.
Oh,
I had no idea where he was, and you know what, Sherman Samson, you talk a big game, but can you walk the walk, but talk the talk?
I'm sorry, how stupid are you? I talk the talk, but can I walk the walk? Oh, I can walk the walk. Damn it. That's why I'm the XGWL Ultimate Champion. I walk the walk. I beat your fucking boss. I beat him the three stages of hell match. That put him to a table on the next XGWL live episode. Monday, I walk walk, I can.
Well, if that's the case, how about we have a match tonight? You versus me, one on one.
You're so fed up with my anarchy. Alex, take on the ladder of my anarchy. Starting with someone willing to put so much agony in the end just for the self-flash. And then you can actually take on all the enemies. Take them on. Then they'll get a shot against me. Big boss. The, Geese Howard, Shao Kahn, F. Bison, Bernstein, the boss of the Anarchists. Now the question is, and in hell, I can even offer my Ultimate Champion against you. Do you want to take the thing on the ladder? Do you want to take the boss? The boss of the Anarchists?
Yeah, that'll be no problem taking your so-called King of Hurt. And after tonight, I'll be dethroning the so-called King of Hurt. Put it on. How about that, little man?
Well, it's a boy thing. Looks like, I guarantee, even if it's me, my anarchist, I guarantee not get this belt from you. You're gonna have to show me this belt. Because I guarantee this. Fuck the hell.
Wait, did we just see, are we going to have Trey Steele taking on Slash the King of Hurt in our main event tonight?
Sure sounds like it.
God damn. But anyway, let's go to our next match here, as Terra Toxic is going to be making her official XGWL debut. And I can't wait for this match to get started. One thing, she had a pretty intense rivalry against Lisa Vasquez down in WCBL a couple years back. I wonder if she's going to be renewing that rivalry soon.
Oh, I definitely would love to see that. Gothic is at their finest.
And speaking of the Beehive, here's one of Lisa Vasquez's teammates. But don't you say that for Tammy?
Oh, I know. I just like to like fuck around.
To my recollection, Ruby is the current XGWL Women's Live Champion. Which means all three members of the Beehive are all champions.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, but the point of the matter is, the XGWL Women's Live title is only intended to be defended on XGWL Live, which again, you can catch Sundays, 11:30 p.m. Eastern, 8:30 p.m. Pacific on the Extreme Tony YouTube channel. It's here we go. Terra Toxic in the black. And like you said, Baxter, thick thighs save lives, but goth thickness saves all.
Oh.
Ooh-wee. Just working on the arm of Terra Toxic. Yeah.
Trying to go for an armbar attempt. And by the way, I don't know if you don't notice, but y'all do realize that Tammy is not at ringside for her Beehive sistering, so to speak, right? Ooh, nice clothesline.
Well, my guess is that Ruby wants to prove herself here on her own, and oh, nice counter. And she might be able to do that tonight. And
Oh, nice monkey flip.
And a cover by Ruby Carter. Come on, ref, do your damn job. Only gets one.
Referee Juan Lopez has been a pretty good referee as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, but in this match tonight, he's probably walking around a little stiffer than usual.
I know.
We're TVMA, so I can't fucking help it, okay?
That's true.
Now Ruby sending Terror Toxin to the corner and, hits him with another monkey flip
to the middle of the ring.
And now Ruby Carter is in control of this contest. Cover, ref, job, one, only. I mean, it's hard to walk around when you got a stiff third member, right?
Come on, man. I thought you weren't going to talk about that.
I know. And anyone, including a member of the Beehive, can do a Russian leg sweep. Hashtag fact. But come on. I can't help it. I mean, for fuck's sake, I follow crazy broads around on OnlyFans. What the fuck do you expect of me?
I swear, you are a bigger horn dog than Joel Knight.
I know. But
Joel Knight's a little bit.
Yeah, but
was going for the toxic turn, but Ruby countered.
Yeah, exactly. We're too focused on sexual deviances. Instead, Ruby Carter just tilt-a-whirl slammed Terra Toxic without all the rotations, and now she's got a single-leg Boston Crab going on as Terra Toxic just tries to get toward the ropes and counters Ruby Carter.
Oh, what a kick to the back.
Exactly. I mean, so much action going on in the ring, we're talking about action in our fantasies. I mean, all I gotta say, I mean, go Cougs on that, but for fuck's sake, can we please focus on the action?
Because that's the one thing I told Joel Knight about being professional, and you guys are being just as professional as him right now.
Well, hey, when you see the TVMA symbol on top of the program, you just can't help but not be unprofessional, as right now, Terra Toxic is putting Ruby Carter into a rest hold.
Tara, wear her down with that sleeper.
Yep.
And you almost said nuts, by the way.
I know.
Hey, wait, what the hell? Hopefully not Tammy. Tara playing mind games here.
I mean, knowing her, considering the fact that one of her Beehive members is in it, she wouldn't mind being a part of the show as long as she's in it. Uh-oh, double arm DDT by Ruby Carter.
Oh, no.
Cover! One! Two!
No. Two and three quarters of that the stretch.
And I know you were a little worried there, Baxter. Oh!
Not so much
about that bitch slap. Just slapped her back a few inches. As right now, the Goth Queen has Ruby Carter in the single leg Boston Crab position as Ruby Carter is trying to defend herself. But no, Ruby Carter denies Tara Toxic the opportunity of being in submission land. Inverted spine on the pine by Ruby Carter, and now Ruby Carter is trying to take advantage, bouncing Tara Toxic's head on the mat like a basketball.
Well, she has to do what she can to get the W.
Exactly. Third monkey flip of the match by Ruby Carter, and now it seems like the member of the Beehive is definitely in control off of that distraction.
And wait, what? Wait, Terra Toxic. Ooh, hits the Intoxicator!
Ugh.
That has gotta be it. Cover. One.
Two.
So many near falls in this contest. Holy hell.
God damn.
Because one thing I have been saying is that Ruby has improved herself for quite some time. And hopefully this is her time to shine against a newcomer here. Oh, what a clothesline.
Well, she can't really shine too much because Tammy will just take the spotlight as usual. But, you know, she's been holding her own in this contest. Right now, She's getting worked over like a cheap trick over Terra Toxic, and now Terra Toxic just suplexed her out of her weave. For at least a little bit.
Oh, come on. She doesn't have a weave. Come on, that's not right. And Terra Toxic...
Uh-oh, intoxic.
Oh, again, for the second time.
Cover.
The cover.
One, two. Hell of an XGWL debut for Terra Toxic. Let me go make this official while y'all talk about it.
What a match between these two. I mean, Ruby did everything she could to try to get the W, but Terra Toxic just proved her tenacity, especially after taking that double arm DDT, which has been Ruby's finisher since day one.
Yep, but I don't think Ruby Cutter didn't have a chance with that toxicity in Terra Toxic.
You're absolutely right on that, amigo. And you see there, Terra Toxic, your winner. And what a way to start things off in her official XGWL debut. She definitely has a good, I'm sorry, I'm a little tongue-tied here, but she definitely has potential to be a star here in XGWL.
Quickness and a thickness. We just love it here. And here comes Tommy Kazarian. What's
hey, Kaz,
he talking about here?
Like you drop into my office. What's going on?
Tony, I'm worried about my upcoming triple threat match. I'm afraid that Aaron Spector and Rick Acid will team up against me since, you know, they're part of the Anarchists.
And look, I'm worried about that too, so here's what we're gonna do. To make things fair, how about I put myself in the match, make this a fatal four-way to help even up the odds a little bit, because two of us is going to be better than two of them.
Sounds good to me. Thanks for looking out for me, T.
Yeah, because we have to look out for each other against these anarchists. See you in the ring.
We have to look out for each other against these anarchists.
Oh, wow. This is going to be a fatal four-way for the XGWL professional title.
I don't think they realize that just because they're on the same page doesn't mean that they could turn on each other in an instant, especially in this context.
Yeah. Well, we'll be right back. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Think and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Yeah. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Yes, sir. Think and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. It's time for you to get into the character. You hit a loser, hit a win, I'm only asking you. Either you beat him or you beat him like an amateur. Either you drive or you get driven like a passenger. The fight's around the corner, so pick the one you want to. Represent your way, go head to head with your opponent. Feel it in the air, tension is electric. The glory's imminent, this is something epic. This for one of you, so what you gonna do? When your enemy is standing right in front of you, are you gonna lose, or are you gonna prove? To everyone that never thought you would, that you could. Cause everything is in your hands, you control this shit. And everything that is the past, it is over. This is now, this is everything that is. So you better make the right pick. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1.
XGWL, I know you've been waiting, but the wait is finally over. Aussie Andy, the one man, Australian invasion, the Australian dream, the green and gold warrior, is finally here, and he's gonna take XGWL by storm. See you soon.
Well, tough words from the one-man Aussie invasion, but
but this freight train is about to collide with an actual freight train in El Toro Extremo. Let's go down to the ring for more action.
Well, I'm really excited about this match. The official XGWL debut of Aussie Andy. Man. And you see there, El Toro Extremo making his way onto the ring by himself. Well, anyway, here's Chris Garrett with the introductions. One thing about El Toro Extremo, he's very accomplished in his own right. Former three-time XGWL professional and pure champion, holding each title three times. Not an easy task to do.
Definitely agreed. But he's taking on the man from down under. With that sexy promo that he's done.
Anyway, here comes Aussie Andy, making his official XGWL debut.
He's got the body of a... He's got the body of a... Of... Oh, one of the performers from the Thunder Down Under.
Does he now? One thing, he definitely has some star potential, does Aussie Andy.
Easy, cool cat slash kitten. I mean, you don't want to... You don't want to basically make the wrong joke about Aussie Andy as, oh, Aussie Andy, early going, getting gut busted.
But you... I meant that as a compliment, because I know he's going to get all the ladies.
Yeah, of course, and a nice inverted belly-to-back suplex by, well, actually, a belly-to-belly, but who cares? Aussie Andy's in control, but only for a little bit. He gets dropped on his knee, and now El Toro Extremo is working on that same knee he dropped on.
Well, that's the one thing that El Toro Extremo does. He's very good at taking his opponent down, and right now, collar and elbow, taking Aussie Andy to the ropes. Juan Lopez asking for a break here. I'm surprised we got a clean break there, because I don't think that El Toro would try to get a cheap shot in.
He couldn't around all that. He couldn't get a cheap shot around all that beef known as El Toro Extremo. But as we, you know, pace ourselves in the early going of this match, we know Aussie Andy is a veteran of his home promotion, Global Wrestling Australia, the Getty Stone Federation. Many other promotions around the world, and I just realized that El Toro Extremo hasn't really made any outside appearances outside of the XGWL, of course.
The only other place that El Toro Extremo has made an appearance is in TWF back in 2007.
I see, but as far as the Anarchists are concerned, don't you think it's about time for El Toro Extremo to start branching out?
Well, that is a good point. Given his history and given his resume that he's built here in XGWL, he definitely could be looked at by other promotions. Oh, what a DDT.
A snap DDT by Aussie Andy, and now he just stomped that shoulder out. Well, that arm out.
Ever since that info, someone can remember he's been pumping his collar.
And of course he has. And now,
his first theme song he ever used back in the day. Look at the Aussie Andy wearing down the big man.
El Toro Extremo in the black and red with the mask. Obviously, given Aussie Andy's sporting credentials, He's in the green and gold, the sporting colors of Australia.
Ooh, another vicious clothesline by El Toro Extremo.
Exactly. But what were you trying to say about El Toro Extremo before you got cut off?
One thing is, like, the last appearance he made other than XGWL was TWF back in the old days, but during his time in TWF, a lot of people thought that El Toro Extremo was Extreme Tony behind that mask. But it's been proven to not be true.
Well, I mean, when you're two inches taller and about 40 pounds heavier, it's hard not to realize the resemblance.
Well, one thing is, Extreme Tony was a bit heavier back in the old days.
Because Extreme Tony was closer to 250 pounds.
Frog splash, frog splash by Aussie Andy, frog splash by Aussie Andy, cover one, two, and no.
Well, yeah, Extreme Tony is down to about 248 pounds now.
Yeah, of course. But still, people probably find a way to, you know, assume that it's him under that gimmick.
And now, oh man, tossing Aussie Andy over the top rope.
Exactly, and now these two men are about to go at it like two wild cats in an entire tiger exhibit. I'm sorry, I'm trying not to make as many Joe Exotic jokes as possible because I haven't seen the damn thing, okay?
And now, as we take the action back in the ring, and Oz yet again pumped up. Ooh!
Yeah, Aussie Andy, with the screams of 1,000 cheering ladies with their tops off. And now Aussie Andy is taking control of this contest.
You wish there were 1,000 ladies cheering topless right now, huh?
But still, El Toro Extremo got his knees up, and now he's back in control, and oh, nice slam by El Toro Extremo. But Aussie Andy counters with a gutbuster. Oh, no, no, no. Uranagi by El Toro Extremo. Or should I say Uranagi, not Uranagi. Either way, it's effective, damn it.
The one thing that El Toro has in his favor is the size advantage, outweighing him by about 60 pounds. And now, what's El Toro doing? Oh no, we've seen this before.
The super duper duper. No, brain bot.
Oh, shades of El Generico with that one.
But even more brutal given the weight and height advantages. And Aussie Andy is hulking back up, so to speak. He's got all the he's got the screams of 1,000 koalas. Oh, DDT off that top rope. Using all the El Toro Extremo's 280 pounds to a disadvantage. Oh, Tiger Bomb! Tiger Bomb 2K20! Tiger Bomb 2K20, I guess. I mean, whatever you want to say about the Tiger Bomb, it's pretty damn effective, ain't it?
And now look at... Oh, I thought he was going to go for Uranagi, but El Toro countered.
That he did, and now his big ass is trying to take advantage, but to no avail.
Now, look at this.
All those mounted punches. I mean, Aussie Andy is trying to take complete advantage of this contest. As right now,
I'm surprised how he's taking the fight to El Toro in this one. Because usually nobody goes after El Toro like that.
DDT to the outside, and yeah, I know what you mean. The dude weighs about 59 pounds less than El Toro Extremo, but he's still kicking his ass, as we see the people of the supposed third-party commentary table stand up.
Wait, that's us right there. What are you talking about, third-party? We're the only commentary team that I know of that is up close and personal to the action, because I know that other commentary teams are up in a prissy little skybox.
Right, of course. And we don't want to end up getting hurt in the middle of the action. So I guess me trying to tell y'all get to the skybox is probably more, well, what the hell am I saying? It would be more feasible instead of us getting caught up in the action, as right now, Aussie Andy's trying to take advantage of that action.
And I'll try to, wait, what the? Goes with the Uranagi cover. Oh, too close to the ropes there.
So close yet so far away off that inverted super Uranagi. I don't know what the hell to call it. Maybe he's probably hiding something that we don't know about these moves. What do you think about this match, Baxter?
I think this is amazing. Definitely Aussie Andy kicking ass, taking names.
Oh, goddamn. I think the ladies aren't too happy about that one.
Speaking of, Aussie Andy's tasting crimson, and right now El Toro Extremo is trying to take advantage, only gets two. But you have to think, the fight that Aussie Andy is trying to put on is only going to die out in a matter of minutes if he doesn't find a way to finish El Toro Extremo off.
Oh! Cover. Going for the cover here.
One, two.
Almost got three off that generic ass pin. Come on, it's generic, but you know what's not generic? Getting powerbombed in the middle of the ring. Cover one, cover two, cover three. No, that's two. Oh! And he's about to stretch him out and make him feel a new type of humble. Nope. Aussie Andy counts.
Damn.
But don't you usually say that when someone applies a camel clutch?
I know. It's just that when you feel that pain in your lower back getting submitted. But when you feel that pain in your lower back getting sharper and sharper, you just can't help but feel humble, damn it.
Oh, what a punch by El Toro. And now Aussie Andy sending El Toro to the apron. Oh, knocking him off.
Yeah, like I said before, all that fight in him is gonna die down if he doesn't finish El Toro Extremo off or attempt to. As right now, El Toro Extremo is just taking his liberties on him.
Well, because you know, that is much easier said than done given the power and the strength of El Toro.
Exactly. Uh-oh, suplex!
Oh, wow, look at that German cover!
One, cover two, cover no.
Oh.
2.99%. I mean, my goodness. And now he's trying to make him humble. Well, not really. He's just punching the life out of him.
Very innovative offense, and now the referee trying to check on his total extremo, see if he's able to continue the match.
I mean, this might be the only time where El Toro Extremo feels weak. Wouldn't you think?
That's the first time I've seen that happen. And wait, what the? Ooh, going for it again.
Cover one, cover two, cover three. Aussie Andy gets one hell of a win to cap off his XGWL debut.
Absolutely, I mean, going, wow.
Holy shit, man.
As we take a look at the highlights while I get myself prepared to announce the winner.
And that frog splash, but El Toro getting the knees up, but then this tiger driver. What a win for his XGWL main roster debut of El Toro, for Aussie Andy against a very tough opponent in Total Extremo. We'll be back with more XGWL action. And folks, welcome back. Hector Diaz, Chris Gary, Baxter Helms with you here. And so far, it's been a very good show so far.
Well, it's been very good and very crazy. Way more united, so to speak. Well, I'm not going to talk about it. But still, point of the matter is, we got a crazy debut coming up next of a special talent that we all probably know soon enough. Let me get to the ring and introduce this one.
Man, I'm just waiting in anticipation here for the debut, main roster debut of Jamari Mito.
Damn.
About Jamari Mito is that he had a very impressive run in WCDL, especially his match against Aussie Andy a couple years back, which for me has to be like one of the best matches in the history of WCDL.
A couple of years back? That was last year, dummy. But
what, it's 2020.
I know, but the point of the matter is, this man has excelled in places like XWE and the WWEF. He's still waiting on that opportunity in Final Destination Wrestling, but here we are with his XGWL debut. And a little thing about Jaden Jett here, who's in the blue and black. He told me, I overheard him saying that he wanted to beat Jamari Mito in under 10 minutes. So that's why I said this match is a special 10-minute attraction.
Well, this Jaden Jett is going to be a fucking dumbass.
Exactly.
And hey. I'm going to say this. I want to see Jaden Jett be covered, his face covered, in face period.
Right. As we
that was gross. That was a gross visualization.
I said face period, meaning his head busted open.
I know what you meant, but it was still a gross visualization.
Right. As we get to business in the ring, Jaden Jett is holding his own against Jamari Mito, who is in the maroon and black. Maroon being one of the colors of his alma mater, Texas Southern University, in the Third Ward of Houston. Oh, DDT by Jamari Mito, who also, by the way, is a former Simulation Football League player for the Houston Hyenas. Which, of course, if you check out the Simulation Football League, they're on Twitch at 11 Sports, and they're just about everywhere. But still, point of the matter is, back to the contest, as we see Jamari Mito getting Jaden Jett into a rest hold.
Hell, that's a dragon sleeper. And if you're applying enough pressure, you can make him tap out right here.
Exactly. As we see right now, Jaden Jett is trying to fight it off, and he does. I mean, first of all, before we even continue this match, do you have any info on Jaden Jett other than what I gave out in the intro? Uh-oh, H-Town Rush coming. H-Town Rush connects. Cover 1, 2, you slow counting ass ref.
Well, as far as Jaden Jett, I wish I could say I do, but honestly, I really don't. I know he's competed a few times on XGWL Live, but other than that, I don't really have much on him. Ooh!
Well, maybe tonight it should be an introduction to him. Hopefully, he'll get more appearances after this. Cover 1 off that DDT and only.
One thing about Jamari Mito is, like, he is, with that combination of MMA training, it makes him a very lethal opponent.
Well, yeah, MMA training and football will do that to you, and uh-oh, another H-Town rush coming. Knee! Damn right. I mean, you would think the dudes learned about, like, 10 different ways to kill you, and uh-oh, here it is, spiral bomb! Nope, 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 nope. Jaden Jet counter.
Damn. I can't believe he countered. I thought he'd be done for.
Yeah, of course, but then again, maybe Jaden Jet's done his homework prior to this match. Maybe he's seen the few times where Jamari Mito slipped up, and actually, uh-oh, wait a minute, he's down the buck in the fireman's carry position. Oh, he did the damn deal. He did the damn deal, but is it enough? Nope, rope break, too close to the ropes, as Jamari Mito takes full advantage of that kip-up. Jaden Jet counters, and now Jamari Mito is looking like he's just seen a ghost.
I'm just wondering, what position did Jamari Mito play in the simulation football league?
He was a wide receiver, tight end, and kick slash punt returner, from what I remember. He only had like a few good, I mean, there was this one clip, and I hate to try and break into the action as right now Jaden Jet's in control, but he had this one clip as right now Jamari Mito is tasting crimson, but he had this one clip where he caught like an 80-yard touchdown reception against the Mexico City Lobos, I think. And uh-oh, speaking of, he's about to get loco, hanging him off the ropes. But yeah, the man can catch an 80-yard touchdown without even turning his fucking head. And that's why, you know, him having 2 years of experience in the simulation football league helps, but it ain't helping him right now. Oh, luckily for Jaden Jet, that plane got deflected.
One thing, there's a handful of talent here on the XGWL roster with some football experience, i.e. Extreme Tony, i.e. Trey Steele. I think Seppa Fumatu, who will be making his XGWL main roster debut on Worldwide Episode 15. Oh!
Viral Bomb move! No, he counters. But still, Jaden Jet is holding his own against a former Houston Hyena in the Simulation Football League.
Oh, shit!
Oh, inverted STO!
Jaden Jet is on the... Look at that face period on Jaden Jet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now he's tasting crimson. And now it seems like Jamari Mito is trying to set things up for the end. He knows that Jaden Jet's ride is over. He knows that Jaden Jet is only a thing in the past, as right now, he is holding his own against a smart mouth kid from Hollywood. Guillotine DDT!
What a DDT! And now Jamari Mito is in control of things here, and ooh, what a leg drop.
And now Jamari Mito is signaling the end. Another H-Town rush coming, and it connects. Cover, one, two, send it in.
Damn. What a win in his main roster debut for Jamari Mito. But we'll go through the highlights here. And this Jaden Jet individual trying to do his best to hold his own, but those strikes, cause this strike game is hella strong, and ooh, it showed it right there. But he did get his licks in with that one, but to no avail.
Absolutely.
Damn. Wait, what the? Wait.
Don't think Jamari's done yet. Uh-oh. As he sends Jade and Jet back in the ring, he's looking for that spiral bomb. He's looking for that spiral bomb. There it is. Ah, there it is. Spiral bomb. What a way to debut. Well, we go from a crazy debut, and props to Jade and Jet for coming out and playing, but tonight just wasn't his night, to a pretty brutal four-way matchup with XGWL Pro Championship implications.
And now making his way to the ring, a man who needs no introduction.
But I'll give him one anyways.
Absolutely. Extreme Tony, very decorated. How many world titles has he won in his illustrious 13-year career in CAW, debuting all the way back in December of 2006, at the age of 23, and winning his world title a month into his debut? And now making his way to the ring, because they're also very accomplished in his career time again. Multiple time former world champion, and of course former 3-time professional champion.
And you know, as I put the mic down for just a second, I still don't realize why Rick Acid comes out to Matt Phoenix's theme.
Wasn't it Rick Acid's theme first before Matt Phoenix used it?
You know what? You're right. You're right. I still don't see why he comes out to
him. Although he should be coming out to the theme of the Anarchists, though.
Of course.
And speaking of Anarchists, his teammate in the Anarchists, the current XGWL Professional Champion, making his debut at the moment of truth, wreaking havoc, and then winning the pro title, winning the championship at the prestige event, the RKDA Send Off Spectacular.
And you know what, I'm surprised that the nameplates on the side are the Anarchist logos, and I'm surprised that knowing how the Anarchists like to take charge over their leader, Sherman Samson, that the Anarchist logo ain't spray painted on the front plate of the title. But here we go, the Fatal 4-Way match is underway, one fall to a finish. The first pin or submission wins this. The champion does not have to be involved in the decision in order for the match to end.
True, as
Aaron Spector is and Tommy Kazarian are fighting it out, as Extreme Tony and Rick Acid are fighting it out, and that's the one match I really want to see in a one-on-one situation.
You mean Aaron Spector versus Tommy Kazarian?
Or
Extreme Tony versus Rick Acid, because you know that Rick S is the former number one overall draft pick of the 2010 CAW draft.
Oh, of course.
Where Tracy was drafted number two overall.
Right. I do remember that. As we see a running DDT by Aaron Spector onto Tommy Kazarian, Extreme Tony and Rick Acid are now back in the ring, and again, it's anything goes. No disqualification, at least I think. No countouts. All the referee can do is just sit there and administer a count or administer a submission when needed.
Well, I can tell you this, Ed Spector and Extreme Tony, they had a rivalry back in Strategic Assault Wrestling.
Mm-hmm. By the way, anyone can do a Russian leg sweep, hashtag fat, we just missed one. Go ahead and continue, Baxter.
Oh! Well, yeah, well, Ed Spector got the upper hand against Extreme Tony over at, STW.
Right. And uh-oh, as we see right now, an inverted Northern Light suplex onto an armbar attempt, a Kimura attempt by Extreme Tony to Rick Acid. Meanwhile, Tommy Kazarian just knocked Aaron Spector off the apron.
Well, that was more of a key lock by the Playmaker. Now Rick Acid tried to get a boot to the Playmaker. Look at this. Oh, blown over DDT by Extreme Tony.
Yes, the action on both sides of the ring are getting hot and heavy as Aaron Spector just bounced off on that position.
The lightning bolt.
Cover one and only. And again, we did say, I did say earlier that, you know, just because they're on the same page against the Anarchists, nice gut wrench suplex by Extreme Tony. Extreme Tony and Tommy Kazarian, they know what's at stake. They know damn well they're going to have to fight each other in order to win that title. Or at least keep an anarchist from winning it.
And oh, as the anarchist right now, or Rick Nassel, is attacking XT after XT delivered a nice back suplex to Aaron Spector.
And now the anarchists are going after one another. Russian leg sweep by Rick Acid to his own man. Twist of fate.
Is he going to retain the title? Cover.
No. 2.99%. But just for a second, you see there? The anarchists fighting each other, and now it's happening again. I mean, obviously, this is every man for himself. This ain't no damn tag team match.
No, you're absolutely right, amigo. Now, XC going after Rick Acid again, and now...
Three, Padre! Pop, 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 pop that ass!
And now, cover! One!
One.
Oh!
And only!
I mean, look at all the world championships that all four of these competitors have held in their careers.
Exactly. Oh, hoo, hoo. Spinning me! Spinning me! Cover!
And
no. And right now, Aaron Spector. Oh, double on DDT and Tommy Kazarian's tasting crimson. Cover one, cover two, cover three. No. 2.99%.
And the playmaker going after Rick Acid, the ref on the arm.
But it's okay, Juan Diaz is shaking that off. And oh, speaking of shaking off, there's no shaking off those punches from Aaron Spector to a bloody Tommy Kazarian.
Damn.
I mean, I'm telling you, this action is hot and heavy. We've seen alliances break away, we've seen the anarchists wrestle each other for a bit, but realize this is every man for himself. It doesn't matter if you're a head honcho, an anarchist, a kamikaze, or what have you. This match is for a title. This match is one fall to a finish. Anything can and obviously will go, and oh, speaking of, a nice running kick. To Aaron Spector, by Aaron Spector to Aaron.
Oh, wait, XT in the ring.
Padre, pop, 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 pop that ass for a second time.
Wait.
Cover one. No, not even. Covered nil. Yet so far away. Oh, ho, ho. Moonsault over Tommy Kazarian. On to Rick Acid. Springboard variety. Twisted fate by Tommy Kazarian. And I think this one may as well be over. But no, Aaron Spector is back up.
A kick out.
Exactly. And see, this is the type of hot and heavy competition that just makes us get wild about this competition. Uh-oh. Double arm DDT by Aaron Spector. Could he retain? No. I mean... Oh, running, trying to go for a spinning knee again does Tommy Kazarian. Instead, he gets twisted inside out like a top.
Absolutely, and XT Days is confused right now.
Yeah, he's a little bit punch drunk, so to speak. I'm pretty sure he's had that a few times in his career.
Yeah, well, of course, because XT's been, ooh! That's not going to help, and look at that, just punching away at the playmaker.
Yeah, he's pretty much taking his liberties, but uh-oh, Rick Acid is right there on him. And it's Anarchist versus Anarchist. Double arm DDT.
Damn. In XGWL, the only place where you can hit your boss and not get fired for it.
Exactly. Like I know.
Okay, so we got all in a DDT.
And the playmaker, what he does best, getting the crowd pumped up.
Uh-oh, and Tommy Kazarian trying to knee somebody except the air.
And look at this. Ooh! And he got Aaron Spector on that one.
Well, he got Rick Acid on that one. Well, Extreme Tony did, but still, point of the matter is, all it's going to take is one big move to change this contest. And speaking of... Tommy Kazarian is taking his frustrations out on Extreme Tony, and I think Rick Acid might do the same to Aaron Spector. Oh, and speaking of, back body drop. actually atomic suplex. Oh, and an inverted neck breaker by Rick Acid.
And as Aaron Spector going after the playmaker, and Rick Acid starting to go after Tommy Kazarian in this one.
Oh, trying to go for a nice little... Point of the matter is, Rick Acid just got taken out. And now, Aaron Spector is bouncing Extreme Tony's head off the mat like a basketball. And trying to take out Tommy Kazarian at the same time, but doesn't get anything. Instead, he gets kicked in the gut. And now, another Brainbuster coming! Brainbuster! Only gets Neil.
Of course, because he's too close to the ropes, and that 6'3" body frame helped him a bit there.
Yeah, it does. Oh, what the fuck? I mean, I know I said it's anything goes, but I didn't mean that. Literally, pop that ass for a third time.
And Rick Acid with the air raid siren.
Air raid siren slammed by Rick Acid. Nothing gets over.
Damn, what a clothesline.
That's right now. Trying to stamp his territory. Instead, gets double on DDT'd. Instead, does Rick Acid. Could Aaron Spector retain over his own brethren? No. And I mean, my goodness, this match is just going all types of crazy. I can barely even keep up with it. Oh, gut wrench suplex by Tony. And Rick Acid's working on his old friend. Well, his new old friend.
One thing is, I think the three of us are having a tough time calling all the action here.
You're right. Because, of course, in these types of situations, it's hard to concentrate on one thing when so many things are happening.
And Extreme Tony's been busted open.
Yeah, the boss has his head busted open till the white meat shone.
Oh, look at that dropkick. Basement dropkick by the playmaker. Oh! And Aaron Spector took an exception to that. Look at those punches.
Off that cross body, no less.
And now the Anarchist teammates are going after it. After each other here. Ooh, what a neck breaker by Rick Acid. This once known as the future legend.
Yeah, of course. I remember those days. Those were tragic.
And now XT.
And could Extreme Tony, the boss of this promotion, at least gain some type of normalcy into the XGWL again? No! Instead, he gets double on DDT for the sacrifice of his own promotion. Cover. No.
I'm surprised Rick Acid made the save there. But it is every man for himself.
As now all hell has simply broken loose. As I think Tommy Kazarian just got RKO'd.
No, he didn't. He rolled out of the ring.
Oh, okay. Well, shit. Stupid me for even realizing that. I mean, for not realizing that. Uh-oh.
Shoulder breaker.
Exactly. And now the two anarchists are fighting it out. Drop kick off the apron. As the two anarchists in this contest, Aaron Spector and Rick Acid, are going at each other. Could this be the final moves of the match? No.
And now all four men back in the ring. Let's see who they pick to fight against here. And Rick Acid with the knee of the playmaker. As Aaron Spector threw Kaz out of the ring.
Could Rick Acid retain? Cover one. Cover two. No. Just one. And only. And now the anarchists are fighting it out against one another. Powerbomb? No. Crucifix powerbomb? Could he get it? No. Netbreaker? No.
Damn, what a counter. And now, cross arm breaker by the playmaker.
I mean, my goodness.
This is by far one of the best Fatal 4-Way matches here in XGWL.
Russian leg sweep by Aaron Spector onto his own damn brethren. And now, inverted neck breaker. Inverted STL neck breaker. And a double arm DDT. No, not even. Another brainbuster. And I think that Aaron Spector just might be seconds away from retaining. But no, Tommy Kazarian counters.
Yes.
And the man that Aaron Spector beat at the RDK Senna Spectacular will beat him for the title.
Uh-oh, twisted fight by Tommy Kazarian. Again, the champion that you believe to be in this decision. Cover one, cover two, cover no.
Damn, there's a lot more to go to our main event. Trey Steele versus Slash the King of Hurt. And then later on, the debut of Nathan Brisbane next XGWL.
I think that match is coming up next as soon as we get done with this contest here.
Yeah.
Oh, what a takedown.
Oh, this could be it. Rick Asher.
Double arm DDT again by Aaron Spector to Rick Asher. But he's too damn close to the ropes.
Yeah, those long arms of Rick Asher with that 6'5" body frame of his.
Wait a minute.
Knee twisted out.
What a counter by Aaron Spector, timing that counter right.
Exactly. DDT by Tommy Kazarian off another counter. And now Rick Asher, net breaker. Inverted net breaker.
And now what's the play? What's it going for? Playmaker.
Andre, pop that ass for a fifth time in a circle.
And now,
and see with the counter.
Netbreaker. Backbreaker. Actually, backbreaker, netbreaker. But still, point of the matter is XT got the cover. XT about to get the win. And Extreme Tony is your new XGWL professional champion, albeit at the expense of Tommy Kazarian. Wow.
What a match between these four.
And at least for some time or another, normalcy has been restored to the XGWL. Now let me go ahead and get up to the ring and announce this as official.
And it's been a while since we've seen this in XGWL. Extreme Tony, a champion once more.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. I guess I got another match to call, so let's get to it.
and making his XGWL debut. Man, I can't believe he's here in XGWL. This guy is an absolute beast. 7 foot even, 385 pounds, from Melbourne, Australia.
Look at this dude, this dude is covered in fucking tattoos.
And I feel bad for his opponent, Jack Webb.
Oh, fuck him.
Now why you gotta
make
him like that? Why you gotta basically say fuck him? The dude's from Glasgow, Scotland. He made the transatlantic flight to get here.
I don't know why. You know, I heard he was whiny and shit. Like, begging.
Oh, you mean because of his emo haircut?
Ooh, what a shoulder tackle.
I mean, I think he doesn't realize that black and red are the colors of the anarchist here. And oh, a series of headbutts by this big behemoth from Melbourne, Victoria, Australia.
I should point out that his name is Jack Webb. What is he related to, the spider Nate Webb?
No, because I don't think that Nate Webb's family goes to Scotland often or any part of the United Kingdom. And oh.
Ooh. What a move!
I think it's over.
Cover! Two! Thanks for coming, Jack Webb.
Bye-bye.
Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. Just get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, look at that move again. That shoulder rack backbreaker. Wait, are they done with him?
Oh shit.
Yeah, I think he's not done. I mean, Jack Webb may have pissed off somebody in the back for wearing these colors, the black and red of the anarchist.
Look at the squeeze in his head.
Yeah, he's trying to give his ass more than a migraine headache. Ugh. But yeah, thanks for coming, Jack Webb. Your clothes are basically in the wood chipper.
Where's Tammy?
Well, hey, she's a valley girl, so what the fuck do you expect?
But there's valley girls that have more class than this bitch. They don't fucking say, like, bitch, shut the fuck up. Fucking talk like a fucking... talk with class.
And folks, we are back. Our main event here for XGWL Charged Episode 91, Slash the King of Hurt versus Trey Steele. And oh man, I don't know how, I'm lost for words here. Because one thing is that, I don't know if you guys know this or not, but Slash the King of Hurt is a former XGW Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion. And you see there, Sherman Samson, the XGW Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion, as he's about to present tonight's competitor against Trey Steele tonight.
You don't have to say tonight twice, dude. We get you.
I know, I'm sorry. A former XGW Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion. He's also a former two-time one half of the XGW Tag Team Champion. One time with Sherman Samson and the other time with AJ Cool. But they did lose their tag titles to Team Deutschland. And now making his way to the ring, the former number 2 overall draft pick on the 2010 CW draft. Days, I can definitely see Trey Steele as a future XGW Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion. So according to Sherman Samson, he's throwing the gauntlet at Trey Steele here. If he can climb the ladder, how Sherman Samson put it together. And here we go as we get this one underway here. Oh! Oh, what
I know
a
what you mean when it comes down to throwing the gauntlet, but isn't Trey Steele the de facto number one contender to the title? Because there ain't nobody else that can actually face off against Sherman Samson at the moment. I mean, we just seen Extreme Tony win the XGWL Men's Professional title from a member of the Anarchists.
And let's not forget that he is avenging his former tag team partner Apollo that the Anarchist injured and forced Apollo to retire.
Right, of course.
But thankfully that Apollo has accepted the job as being the head trainer in WCDL Cover 1.
And only. But still, I get what you mean when it comes down to Apollo accepting a training gig. But what I think is that Trey Steele is only the number one contender because there's nobody out there aside from who I just mentioned. Uh-oh, powerbomb off the scoop position, off the actually gut wrench position. But, well, actually off the deadlift position, but still only gets one. Still, aside from Tommy Kazarian, aside from, yeah. Aside from Jimmy McMurray, the Nightmare, and another deadlift powerbomb by Trey Steele, but aside from Tommy Kazarian, Jimmy McMurray, you know, maybe even one of the Anarchists, Rick Acid, and another third deadlift powerbomb, by Trey Steele, but aside from the names that I mentioned and keep getting cut off for, I think there are some legitimate contenders for the XGWL World Heavyweight Ultimate World Heavyweight title. We just haven't truly figured them out yet, and as of right now, Trey Steele is holding his own against Slash, the King of Hurt.
I'm thinking that they're not coming stepping forward because of who is protecting Sherman Samson.
Oh yeah, of course, AJ Cool, Slash the King of Hurt, El Toro Extremo, Rick Acid and Aaron Spector.
It's like, do you want to mess with them?
Well, if you have a death wish, but I doubt it.
Oh! Modified Backbreaker by Slash the King of Hurt, and this could definitely be a hoss fight for the ages here between these two.
Well, of course, even though Trey Steele has a 21-pound weight disadvantage against Slash the King of Hurt.
Wait, what the? Oh! Thousand Lake Plunge! And, oh, come on now. Sherman Samson.
And you know what? Come to think of it, Baxter, we haven't gotten your opinions on, you know, who might end up being in the title picture, but what are your thoughts about the current XGWL Ultimate World Heavyweight title picture at the moment?
Definitely Trey Steele, Tommy Kazarian, Nightmare, Jimmy McMurray, and yeah, Rick Acid, definitely. And, yeah.
As
I would also love
right
to see Jamari Mito and Aussie Andy get a crack at the belt, too.
Hey, so can Nathan Brisbane.
Mm-hmm. Well, they just made their debuts tonight.
Yeah, and we got a long time to come. We got a long time to come before that. As of right now, since Trey Steele is dominating Slash.
If you haven't noticed, Sherman Samson slid in a steel chair in there.
I mean, is this no disqualification? I didn't read it off as it being one.
Well, you know how the anarchists roll.
Anarchy is the key to victory, and if they don't get what they want, they get complacent and pissy.
Because they will not hesitate to bend the rules or break them.
Yeah, of course. But really, it's the anarchists' world. We're all living in it, and right now, Trey Steele is trying to at least bring some type of decency, nice clothesline, like what Extreme Tony did minutes earlier.
Man, I still can't believe that Extreme Tony is the new XGW professional champion after so many years of being without a championship here in XGWL.
I mean, come to think of it, his most recent title was outside the XGWL, holding the Hell's Gamut title for that United entity, Virtual Wrestling United, of course.
One thing is, like, how many world titles that Extreme Tony had? About 20 or something?
And Thousand Lake Plunge. And I think this may seal the deal for Trey Steele in his quest to become the XGWL Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion. No. Slash counters. And now Slash. Northern Light Suplex only gets one.
Damn, I was surprised he was able to pull off such a move.
Well, as big as he is, you gotta pull off everything. Oh! Like that stroke. Like that front-facing Russian leg sweep, that is.
Anyone can do that.
Yeah, of course. Unless your name rhymes with... unless your name has a J in each initial. Cover one, cover two. I'm sorry, I had to say that shit.
And look at this. Trey Steele looking to wear down the King of Hurt. With that seated abdominal stretch. And, oh!
That formerly San Diego stretch that Jim Tony has done in the past.
He's retired it for damn good reason. And speaking of, Slash may just retire Trey Steele here. No! Trey Steele counters. And now, obviously, these two men are going back and forth right now. These two men are just... Oh, Luthez pressed by Slash.
Damn, punches and bunches and now Trace Hill's been busted open.
Yeah, he's tasting crimson. He's feeling that white meat showing. Oh, and he just might end up having a broken elbow to go with it.
And now sending Slash to the ring apron. And
suplex into the ring. Slash is on wobbly legs right about now as Trey Steele is trying not to get distracted by Sherman Samson. And Slash. Oh, back body drop.
Taking advantage of the distraction by Sherman Samson.
Exactly. I mean, I won't be surprised if Sherman Samson ends up getting kicked out soon. Slash with that agility.
Which is very surprising for a man his size.
Suplex by Trey Steele.
And now look at this. Trey Steele trying to get the crowd behind him.
Keyword, trying to, but it's going to take more than the crowd to get him on his side. And Slash counters with a clothesline. And now he, as big as he is going up to the high rent district.
Oh, Lord.
And that's why you shouldn't go up to the high rent district when you're 6'6 and 300 pounds. Come on, man. What are you thinking?
Well, I've never really seen the King of Hurt go to the top rope.
Yeah, and I've never seen an elephant fly other than Dumbo, but for fuck's sake, man. When you're 6'6 and nearly 300 pounds, you shouldn't be doing that shit. Buckle bomb. Well, actually, Baldo bomb, but still, it's effective. As Slash is looking to put Trey Steele away, Trey Steele counters, clothesline.
That's what he has to do, just having the heart of a champion here. Look at this. Ooh, again with a 1,000-leg punch.
Could this be it?
One, two.
Oh, hell no.
To the no. Two and 99% if there ever was one off of that 1,000-leg plunge.
And what is the pep talk that Slash was received from Sherman Samson? Oh man,
annihilate and dominate. That's probably what the pep talk was. Cover one by Slash. He was probably told in the locker room earlier after that little incident that Trey Steele and Sherman Samson had to annihilate and dominate. Which is what he's pretty much doing right now, trying to seal the deal. Instead, gets clotheslined again.
Clothesline.
And now, 1,000-leg plunge for the third or fourth time in this contest, but I think this may as well be effective. Cover. One.
Cover.
Two.
One.
And that. No! That's another near fall.
And now, Trey Steele looking for. I think he's going for the Rings of Saturn again.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I think this may as well spell doom for Slash the King of Hurt with Sherman Samson watching on. Knowing that this man may be knowing that this man is gonna get his title match sooner than later and he taps out.
And it's over.
Slash the King of Hurt taps out.
And like that's all he can stand and he can't stand no more.
Is that a Popeye reference or are you just pulling my rib?
Oh, that's a Popeye reference,
amigo. Ah, but still, what an amazing match, what an amazing contest. And Trey Steele is going to get his opportunity to become the Ultimate World Heavyweight Champion down the line. Let me go ahead and make this official, and we can go ahead and call it a night.
Who's next in this ladder then? That Sherman Samson was talking about, but just one anarchist down and five more to go.
Exactly. but we won't know until we get there, and hopefully those obstacles will be few and far between, but we gotta go. For Baxter Helms, I'm Chris Gary, wishing you como siempre adios, peace my peoples in one love world, and we'll talk to y'all next time. Later!
Tape machine running!